20. It's been a long season for him. He won the collegiate indoor championships in February and then won the outdoor championships. It's tough to do and then come all the way to the Olympics at the end of August. First of three semi-finals, the men's 400. They've cut a round out of this, so it gets very tight right now. Almost set. From the inside, it's Sambu, Kenya, Milazar, Mauritius, Wariner of the United States, Alhard, Banner, Zimbabwe, Blackwood, Jamaica, DeJones, a fast finisher and a fast starter tonight for France, Ben Bredigen and also Kakaya. Left to screen, look at DeJones go hard. Wariner is flying. White vest coming up to halfway. Blackwood's in a good spot. First two to qualify. It's going to be tight at the top and it's going to be fast, I think. DeJones, Blackwood, Wariner coming hard. Milazar in lane two. Wariner clearly in front at the bend. Second to Jones. Blackwood strong at the end. Wariner hanging on. DeJones tying up. Blackwood trying to get to him. But Wariner's going to win and looks terrific. 44.88. They are inside that 45 barrier. It was Wariner, Blackwood and DeJones around the money. But the American right now is the early favourite.
Brilliant run from the starting blocks. He really got himself out there, set himself up for a great race, and there was no way he was going to let them run him down. For a while in the home straight there, I thought Jamaican and the Frenchman are going to get him, but they had no hope. He was very composed, very comfortable. I must say, at the start, I noticed that they got into the set position and the gun went very quickly. Here they are coming off the turn. Warren is very comfortable. Not a dissimilar action to Michael Johnson. Short arms, just doesn't stand as upright. Nice, comfortable, easy, relaxed last 100. Striding out quite well. You can see DeJones is really almost overstriding, trying to stay there. And Blackwood is working very hard to get DeJones. Great race between those two, but Wariner is easy and comfortable and almost stops as
near the national record holder, but his personal best is back in 99. He's in one. Binu of India in lane three. He broke the national record in the heat. They're getting down the Indians, 45-4. Galkin, we're seeing now, the Russian, he's really good. He's taken his best time from 44.5 to 44.8 at the national championships. He ran 44.9 in the semi and then 44.8. So he qualified in 45.4, but there's a bit left for him. Watch out. Derek Brew, I should say, third in the American trials. He's coached by Antonio Pettigrew, who won the gold medal in 1991 in Tokyo in the 400 metres.
Had a long career, tall, lanky runner was Antonio Pettigrew. This young man, the Americans, they dominate this race.
Chris Brown, 25 years of age. He was the quickest in the heats. He's also the national record holder over 800 metres for Bahamas. You just keep seeing Bahaman athletes, particularly their women, excelling, don't we?
The Caribbean do very well, not only the Bahamas.
Speaking of the Caribbean, the giants of the Caribbean in terms of all sports, Cuba, Jamin Lopez, second in the Ibero-American Championships. Well, here's a blast from the past. Alejandro Cardenas of Mexico. He was third behind Michael Johnson in Seville in 1999. Irina Zavinska has been coaching him.
That's interesting. Irina, of course, beat me in Mexico when I was 17, in 200 metres.
She won seven Olympic medals all up. And Davian Clark of Jamaica, a relay specialist in lane eight. Probably look for lanes 3, 4 in particular, and maybe 5. Just the two to get there. Seen some fast running in the first of the semi-finals. 44.87, the winning time for Wariner. 45 dead for Blackwood, and DeJones in 45.01. There's Brown, he's 25. There's Brew. The Americans have such a history in this event.
Huge history, huge history.
Off, Sestak in one, Slovenia. Binu, India two, Galkin, Russia three, out well. Then Brew, Brown out really hard in lane four, quickly a five, I should say. Goes past Lopez. Cardenas two from the left, and Clark is out fast in lane number eight, the Jamaican. See the gold vest of the Jamaican Clark, but look at the blue vest of the Bahamian runner. That is Brown. five. Guru's got a good sider on him, and the Russians well placed. The top three look to be five, four, and three on the bend. It's Brown, Guru, and Galkin. They're clear of Clark. This will be a hard last stretch. Guru strong. The Russian will try and get up for second. He won't make it. And Clark coming home hard will get second, I think. Guru gets there. Maybe Clark just beating Brown for second with Galkin third. A bit slower than the first semi-final.
Brilliant race. I actually thought at the start that Galkin almost broke. He was very quick off the mark, much quicker than the others. There's Derek Guru. Won it fairly comfortably off the turn. Had to chase Brown down. Brown had a go all the way, but was run down at the end and will have to wait. I'm pretty sure Clark, Jamaican, did get past him on the line.
He looks upset, but he will get second place, and that'll get him into the final. And it was a good run out in lane eight. But
here we come off the turn, and Brown's still leading. He's really worked hard. He wants to get through to this final. Brew's looking a lot more comfortable and has run over the top of him. He's tired, though. There's no knee lift there. Although he has relaxed, you can tell he's dropped his arms, having a look around. Whereas Clark, the Jamaican, is running home. Long arm action, low knee lift, and I think Clark actually qualified through second.
So the Americans have taken the first two semi-finals here in the 400s. Francique there from Granada, world indoor champion this year, won in London. He's only lost two of his nine races this season. He's been in great form. In the starter's hands. Almost set. Third semi-final, men's 400.
Oh.
Well, Schultz has stayed down in lane one, didn't get up, and there's some confusion going on here.
I wondered why they were being held for so long, because in the first heat we saw, or in the second heat rather, we saw Galkin, I thought, break. And I was thinking, this is a long... In the first round, or the first heat, he was very quick with the gun after they got into the set position.
The problems in lane one, Ingo Schultz, the tall German. He's the European champion from a couple of years ago. He just didn't get up off the blocks at all. And it's just some communication problems. It's the American, Otis Harris. Second in the Olympic trials. Second in Munich the other day in a meet between the Americans and the Germans. Carlos Santos goes from fourth in the Dominican Republic. He was the national record holder until Felix Sanchez, the hurdler, came along and broke the flat record. That's how good he is.
One of my favourites. Can't wait for the 400 hurdles.
These blokes can't wait for the result. They've done their work. Sitting, watching, waiting.
Indication of the heat in the stadium, even at this hour.
Almost set now. Third semi-final of the men's 400. So Schultz, Germany, the inside. We walk with Nigeria to Albishi in three from Saudi Arabia. Four, Santa, Dominican Republic. He's up to Harris, the American, then Francique out fast, three from the left, out really fast, goes up to Benjamin of Great Britain and Simpson of Jamaica. So the Jamaicans have caught lane eight again. Simpson out wide, lane eight, Francique Granada in lane six, Santa Dominican Republic in four, Albishi, Saudi Arabia in the green vest in lane three, off the bend, Francique clearly in front. Harris can't quite get to him. Simpson rallying out wide. Francique clear. Harris closing late. Closing very well. And here's Simpson out wide. Will get them all, I reckon. Probably does. 44.98. Harris second and Francique just tying up in the end.
Otis Harris ran out very slowly. Had to work very hard to win that from so far back. Off the turn. What a race that last 100 metres. Desperation.
That's almost the wrong way to win a race.
No, there's no wrong way to win a race. Every win is a good win. There's Simpson. Ran beautifully up the last 100 metres, looking quite composed.
Cathy, you thought Wariner would be a winner before the semi-finals. Are you still convinced that he's the man to beat?
Yeah, he looks the sharpest to me.
Here we have Francie coming off the turn. Otis Harris knows he's got a lot of work to do. He's really digging deep. He's got the teeth together. Francique losing his composure. He's trying really hard to hold it all together, but he's tying up. He has got a big dose of lactic acid pumping through his system, and Simpson comes through on the outside and probably takes them both. Harris has had to work, and I hope he doesn't run the final that way. Simpson running all the way through the line, dipping up the line, in fact.
Three semi-finals concluded now, and that one also inside 45 seconds. We haven't seen anybody outstanding here through the rounds. Wariner has looked good, but what has happened is that Michael Johnson has retired, and so when Michael Johnson's retired, suddenly the race has taken on a different look. Start list will come up in a moment. There are three Jamaicans and three Americans in this. Blackwood, Simpson, Clark, and Drew, Wariner, and Harris.
Wariner's the man I'll be watching. Fascinating to see a white American running the ball.
Michael Blackwood's in lane one. He was the number one in the world 2 years ago. Commonwealth champion, Jamaican sportsman of the year that year. He's a very good cricketer, but he went for athletics because he wanted to go to America to get an education. Ended up in Oklahoma. Here's Leslie Deschaune. He's the French record holder. Haven't they got a history in 400 metre running with Mary Jo Perec, who's sitting right in front of us, and Kathy Freeman's alongside of us. Kathy, great 800 final. Let's hope this is as good.
Let's hope.
Deschaune in lane number two. Now, lane three is the first of the Americans, Derek Brew. His coach is Antonio Pettigrew. He ran in the final in Sydney 4 years ago. Derek has the fastest personal best in the field of 44.29, but that was set 5 years ago. He was third in the American trials. Well, no white American has won this race for 40 years. Mike Larrabee won in Tokyo in 1964. Markin won of Russia in 1980 when the Americans boycotted, and Alberto Wanzarina, the Cuban, won in 76, but we haven't had a white American win the 400. This has been their event, the Americans. They've dominated, and Wariner is the favourite. Otis Harris has been coming on strong. He was second in the Olympic trials, and he's come to Europe and maintained that form. 22 years of age. So the Americans, could they clean sweep as they did in 1988 when Darren Clark was fourth behind the big three in Seoul? This is the surprise packet. I think Brandon Simpson, 22 years of age, the Jamaican champion, a real hope. Davian Clark's wife has already run in the hurdles tonight. He's a fine relay runner. I'm not sure if he's quick enough though. 45.11 is his fastest this year. Only 3 men have broken 45 seconds through the rounds here. Quite surprising. And on form this year, this man was the equal favourite going in with Wariner, and that's Alain Francique. But he hasn't run so strongly here, and he's found himself in lane number eight, and that won't help.
No, running a little bit blind on the outside there. It's very hard to pace yourself in a four anyway. It's the long sprint, and it's a matter of control and speed, which don't normally go together. Out there, he's got to do it all alone.
Kathy, you've fancied Wariner's chances, haven't you?
Absolutely. I mean, the 400 is a true test of being aggressive and yet being relaxed, you know. So I think he can win.
We're about to find out. Hart, Blackwood, he is a fighter. He'll need to be tonight from lane one. Expect it to be close. Expect changes to happen in the last 50 metres. Fast finishes to come on. The form says there's not much between first and eighth here. They're about to go in the men's 400 final. Three Americans and three Jamaicans. They make up three quarters of the field. Ready.
Okay.
So from the inside, Blackwood, Deschaune, Brew, Wariner, Harris, Simpson, Clark, Francique. Pretty even start. It's hard to pick one early. Have a look at the staggers. Out wide is Francique with Clark moving up. Harris on Simpson. That's four from the left. Wariner controlled early. Basically, we've got seven in a line at halfway. Francik in lane eight. Harris coming through. Wariner. Bruce up to him. DeJones a fast finisher in two. Blackwood's in the front. Harris leads. Wariner accelerates. Goes up to him. Harris and Wariner. They settle on it to fight it out. Wariner's taken the lead. Harris can't quite match him. The Americans are going to go one, two, three. And Wariner wins. From Harris and Brew. 44.01 unofficial.
Jeremy Wariner's advisor, Michael Johnson, who won the last four, said he didn't have a ritual before he ran a race, but he certainly did afterwards, and that was to stand on the dais and have a gold medal put around his neck. And now this young man's going to have the same. 20 years of age. What a future has this boy got?
He's exactly what me at 20.
Well, you picked him from the start, Cathy, the first time you saw him here, and he's run 44 seconds flat. This is a fabulous breakthrough for him. Very few men have broken 44 seconds.
He just looks magnificently sharp.
Sensational composure going down the back straight. Harris ran out very fast for the first two, as he did in earlier rounds. The three boys celebrating together. I like that. There's no difference in colour there.
It's the fourth time they've clean swept the 400 at the Olympics. We've got to go back to 1988, before that 1968 in Mexico City, and then way back to 1904. So there's a lot of history here.
Here we have Harris leading Wariner into the straightaway, and really those guys are pumping. They both want it. Harris is moving very hard, and Wariner's doing what Cathy said he can do, or you have to do, is relax. He's relaxed, coming through short arm action, fairly short stride, but he's relaxed and he's keeping it moving. Harris in for second, looking good, exhausted, and Brew for third.
Super fast time, just 7 men have broken 44 seconds, so he's getting into elite territory. Well, you talked about the Americans having to go through the trials and the rigors of getting here. They've been able to come here and they've come in great shape, and who knows in the women's 400 now, I mean, and the 400 hurdles. They haven't been over-impressive in the round so far, but maybe they can produce it in the finals when it counts, because that's what's happened here tonight. They've blown the Jamaicans away, haven't they?
Absolutely. And I tell you what, we're still looking at a very good 4x4 competition.
It'll be very exciting.
Three very excited young men.
The story of the race was that after, as we see the Jamaicans gathering there with Francik from Grenada, after 200 metres, there were basically 7 men still in the same stagger. It was hard to really pick a leader at that stage.
Yeah, I thought Wariner ran really, fairly conservatively the first 300, and it was Harris who was absolutely fitting.
He was lucky that he had Harris on the outside of him, because he was a great marker. Harris was the trendsetter in the first 300, in fact, for the first 350 metres of the race, and Wariner could keep an eye on him. He would have read that race well. He would have known the way Otis was going to go out, or Harris rather, and there's Harris' tongue and his eyes doing a lot of hard work at the end, trying to will himself there. Warren is so cool and relaxed, short arm action, swinging the head slightly. You can see there's a fair bit of effort going in there, and he's about to cross the line where he swings his arms in the air and starts celebrating. And he deserves to celebrate.
Same coach as Michael Johnson and advised by Michael Johnson. That is good information. Here's the news.